Did you ever wanted to drill a few holes in your MacBook Pro? Here is a complete guide on how to do it. Welcome back to TakeApart. This 13-inch MacBook Pro with Retina display will get a little cooling upgrade, allowing fresh air to directly enter the cooling fan. MacBook sucks air in from this side and pushes out hot air from here. As the cooling fan is located right here, we will drill a few holes right on top of the fan in this place. I have prepared PDF document including template for holes pattern and all needed measurements. Link is in the description. Let's do it. Unscrew 10 P5 screws holding bottom cover. Oh, and if you need tools like my ones, head into the description and look for product links. Having the right tools is crucial. Insert plastic tray bar below display hinge and pop the cover. Here you can see exact location of the cooling fan and also where the hot air exits the MacBook. And here, air enters and passes by all the components, and then is sucked into the cooling fan. But with the holes on the cover, we should lower the temperatures of the air entering the cooling fan, without drastically interrupting airflow around other components. Here is PDF document I was talking about. It has the template and all necessary info and measurements. Link in description. First thing first, the central hole must be drilled. It should be located 66 mm from the back and 65 mm from the right side of the MacBook cover, just like on the PDF. I used 1 mm drill bit for the central slash pilot hole. Get paperclip or SIM ejector tool from Apple, print and cut out template from PDF document, and align center holes with paperclip or SIM tool. Now secure the template with clear tape on MacBook cover. Do it properly, as last thing you want is to have the template move during the drilling. Double check if center holes are still aligned and happy drilling. I recommend to drill pilot holes with 1 mm drill bit first. Once you're done with pilot holes, remove the template and you should have this nice pattern of holes. Switch the drill bit for 2 mm one and enlarge the holes. Do not use larger drill bit than 2 mm. I left center hole smaller as I like it this way better. You should end up with something like this. If executed properly, the holes will look like from Apple. And good thing is that if you cover the new holes by hand, leg or anything else, MacBook will still suck the air from its original place. There are 131 new holes and please somebody double check that. As you see, center hole is on top of the fan shaft and diameter of the hole's pattern is matching diameter of MacBook cooling fan. All this and much more can be found in the PDF document. So head over to my website and look for download section. Ah, the holes just look fantastic. Let's screw the cover back on. Two screws on top or below the screen hinge are the two shorter ones. And now the test of the new cooling holes. I used Cinebench and monitored CPU core average temperature and fan speeds. On top of the screen is original MacBook and bottom of the screen shows MacBook with drilled holes. During the test was the CPU average temperature difference around 10 degrees Celsius. This alone is good enough reason to drill the holes. But if we look at the fan speed, we can see that original MacBook cover maxed out RPMs of the fan at 6200. RPMs, while drill cover kept fan speed at maximum of 4750 RPMs. So yeah, cooler and quieter. And note, if the fan speeds would be same for original and drill covers, the CPU temperature difference will be even larger. More tests and tips will come later. Subscribe now and don't miss out. Thanks for watching and see you next time.